I present to you our 2019 Western speaker, LaTanya LaFay Sherman.
Thank you so much. Hello, hello, hello. Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? Good. Hey, family. How y'all doing? I'm in the right place at the right time with the right folks for the right reason, right? Just to make sure we're going to get all of this out of the way first. On the count of three, that's my family. I said on the count of three. Who started? Security, security. One, two, two and a half, three. I know it because I heard it when they were marching in. I say, okay, I see what time it is. Right place, right time, for the right reasons. Now, graduating class of 2019, congratulations. Graduating class of 2019, congratulations. It is definitely an honor to be a part of this beautiful ceremony tonight as we celebrate you and this amazing accomplishment. And thank you so much to your campus president, the entire family of Fortis, for allowing me to be a part of this celebration as we celebrate you tonight. Now, when he called, as he said, it was an instant, sure, I'm in, let's go, field trip. And it's because I believe in the work of Fortis. I believe in the purpose of Fortis. I believe in the brand, the product, and that also means I believe in you. Because you're attached to that. You're attached to that promise. This leg of your journey, it's not accidental. I hung up the phone and I began to jot some notes like, okay. I said, yeah, now what should I say? I mean, I only have 3 hours to speak, so. No? Don't worry, we're serving breakfast on the way out. Turning this into a slumber party, no one knew. And you know, as the date was approaching, here it is, the deadline is coming up. I promise you I've written and rewritten this commencement at least 12 times. At least 12 times. I had all kind of intros ready. I had all kind of scriptures together. I said, oh, this is good. We all had plans to be here. Here on this campus, in this room, here to toss our tassel and to hit our two-step. Oh, I was the only one ready for the two-step. Don't worry about it. Only to be put on pause by Hurricane Barry. I say, well, look here. I was ready. We were gonna celebrate that night. That night was our night to celebrate, but we had to be put on pause. But you know what? We were delayed, but not denied. Here we are. We are in this room celebrating you and your success, your accomplishment tonight. And listen, it's no small feat that you are here. This did not happen by accident. There were days that sometimes you just feel like you couldn't see the light at the end of the tunnel. Okay, I'm talking to myself. I'm sure there were days that you had to dig deeper and just believe that all things would eventually work together. Eventually. Eventually was coming. I can't see it. Can you? Hey, eventually, if you could, aisle three, come get me. Guess that's only me. I don't know about you, but some days I look back and I'm like, whoo, I was sitting on the curb thinking, never would have made it. Put that on repeat. Fix it, Jesus, fix it. And I think to myself, if I had given up, taken the easy route, found another excuse, or would have put myself on hold yet again. Because that's what life does to us sometimes. Sometimes it makes us put ourselves on hold because we have so many other people that we need to tend to. So many other people's issues that we need to put forward to get the day done. So many other issues that say, well, you know what, today, I'll take care of this and I'll get back to me tomorrow. And then I often tell myself, sometimes, Sandra, you got to remember, you got to self-improve before you help improve. I'm going to say that again because somebody missed that. You have to self-improve before you help improve. Now, we say we want to empower our families. We say we want to build stronger communities. And we say we want there to be a shift in the atmosphere. Well, how can that happen if we are not a part of the change? Simple questions that need answers. Class of 2019, you are the difference. Woo! I don't know if you got that memo today or not, but you are the difference. And I'm honored to be in a room filled with difference makers. Look around this auditorium. I know we're here to celebrate you tonight, but look around the auditorium. The room is filled with those who love you, those who sacrificed with you. But you know, tonight we're here to cheer you on because as a token of our appreciation, we want to say thank you for your sacrifice. We want to say thank you for your efforts. We want to say thank you for your courage, your passion. Thank you for not giving up. It's something about that commitment. When you keep going, you keep going, you keep going, that one no sometimes will make you want to just go ahead and sit on down. Yes, some days get hard, but you did not quit. But we're here now. We're showing up and we're showing up. Are we ready? Because we're here now. You'd be foolish to think that you escaped some challenges, though. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I'd be lying to you if I say, oh, that's okay. The hard part is over. Life continuously happens. Those issues, those obstacles are waiting for you on the next leg of your journey. But I have a magic word for you. You didn't know this was going to be a magic carpet ride now, did you? Put on your thinking caps. The magic word is poof. Poof. As elementary as it is, I need you to keep that handy because you'll need it. For every challenge, I want you to sit back and take a deep breath and just tell it, poof. Tell it to be gone. Every time you think of quitting, say, poof, be gone. Every time you get stuck in that train, seems to keep derailing because of work, family, life, you can't get it on track, just tell it, poof. P-O-O-F. Power over obstacles forever. You have the power over those obstacles. You are part of that promise. You are part of that purpose. You look at it and you tell it, poof. I found that God will not give me a vision without giving me provision. You have to trust. You have to believe that. But see, some days we kind of tend to forget that because we have to spend time adjusting, readjusting, committing, and then balancing, adjusting, readjusting, committing, and balancing. Oh, it's a never-ending cycle. Hello, life. All of my goal-getters, where are you? I think I saw that on somebody's hat. Somebody's hat had something about goals on it. Where you at? Stand up, me. Let me see you, me. Hey, me. Goals. Now, you know what? Here's one that I love about goals. Going over all little steps. Because, see, if you don't pay attention to detail, you're bound to forget something. If you don't pay attention to detail, you'll get detoured and don't know how to find your way back to the point of destination to get you where you were intending to go in the first place. Set those goals. Continue to be the trailblazer. Pay attention to detail and let this accomplishment not set you on a tone to where people can't talk to you. Now you got that new title. Oh, don't act like you never ran across the type. Got a new certificate. Don't know how to act. Got period poo. Okay, hashtag retweet that. Let this accomplishment enhance the level of greatness that your family and your friends and that the family of Fortis already saw in you. They believed in you from jump. And you know what? Here's the challenge that I really want to leave with you. I want you to learn how to encourage others to invest in themselves the way that you have. If it wasn't important to you, you would have never saw this through. If it wasn't important to you to make a difference or break whatever generational curse it may have been, or whatever it is that you were suffering through and nobody knew, is it just me? You gotta do it with a smile on your face because you know we are going through. You have to trust God through the process, but faith without works is dead. So as soon as you sit still, you ain't cheating nobody but yourself. I want you to walk in purpose, and I want you to be proud in your purpose because you know you're doing it to fulfill your mission. And before I close and get out of the way, because I know you don't want to turn this into a slumber party. They weren't too happy about my breakfast idea. My grandfather, the late Reverend Jesse Lafayette Sr., he left a few things with me that really just stuck with me throughout my life. And no matter what leg of the journey I was going through, it was like a plug-in. It always made sense. I thought Papa just talking. He a preacher, it sounds good. But no, Papa meant it. He lived it. And he wanted that to stay with me so when he wasn't here, I had something that would guide me through and keep me close to the promise. Three R's in life. Remind myself of it daily. Respect for God, respect for self, respect for others. Put it all in perspective. Respect for God, respect for self, respect for others. In every walk of life, it doesn't matter what you do, where you're going, who you're talking to, put some respect on that. Because sometimes I get hard to understand if ain't no respect somewhere in the equation. Oh, it's just me? Okay. Pop quiz, you ready? Beep. Beep. Crowd participation is everything. Graduating class of 2019, the five P's of life. Prior preparation prevents poor performance. Stay ready, you don't have to get ready. He been over here talking the whole time. What are the five P's? Okay, okay, okay. We're in now. And you know what? We are family. And I believe that a family that prays together stays together. Would it be okay if you held the hand that was close to yours? Let us pray. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine are the kingdom and the power and the glory.
Amazing. Can you come and do this like every week?
For as long as you have.
I have a plaque that you're going to hang in your office, hopefully.
I am.
It says, Fortis College, your life powered by learning. Presented to LaTangela Faye Sherman, Max 2941. Thank you for your valuable insights and inspiration. Fortis College, Class 2019 commencement speaker.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you.
And when Tinka and I were talking about Murder Coming to Speak at our commencement, we talked about the idea of, instead of an honorarium to her, what if we gave a donation to a charity in her name? She thought it was the greatest idea. And the charity, she said, was, please, it's St. Jude's Hospital. And do you want to say anything about St. Jude's Hospital? We have a check that we're going to give to St. Jude's Hospital in Los Angeles name.
Thank you.
Look, with all of the work that they do, especially right here within our community and across the nation, Mr. Thomas had a vision and he saw it through. That is just one of the most valuable lessons that I can see. You know, as an entertainer, it was his dream to do well around the world, and it has just lived on. And I appreciate y'all so much for this.
Yeah. Let's get this in the mail tomorrow.
Thank you.